getting results. You're watching WHNT News 19 at 10.
24 hours after Christmas flooding.
It's not over. Just because you saw the water go down from yesterday, it may not be over yet. We may still have some more issues.
Don't let your guard down. The flooding providing a cruel reality check.
We were told that this was not a flood zone. So, never give it a second thought because this has never happened.
Families regroup, wondering where to turn next. A Christmas blaze at the U.S. Space and Rocket Center.
The building that caught fire is an old Mission to Mars building.
But that mission changed to calling a fire truck.
Several parts of the Tennessee Valley remain underwater. Many areas still dealing with very dangerous situations, and this is why. Check out this exclusive video that was sent in to us from Pete Dobbs. Incredible video from Pete. Drone footage here. And it shows just how serious this flooding situation is in so many places. This is shots of Ditto Landing in Huntsville, the Hobbs Island Road area that leads into Ditto Landing's marina. It is submerged. It is underwater. Check out this video sent in to us from Awaken Films. This is Wheeler Dam on the Tennessee River. This is between Lauderdale County and Lawrence County. Several of the spillways, as you can see, open on the dam, releasing a lot of water. This vista just breathtaking here, but it shows you how dangerous it is, and we'll show you more of the aerial footage of the flooding later. Madison County emergency responders staying on top of the latest events, and Mother Nature prompted a meeting a few hours ago. First responders and emergency managers gathered for a briefing early this evening to get the latest information from the National Weather Service. If you live in an area prone to flooding and you plan to leave home tomorrow, you are encouraged to leave early to avoid getting stuck in your neighborhood.
Right now we're dealing with all the runoff that has drained into the Tennessee River, and the TVA is having to send more water down the river, so that is raising the stream levels, and it's kind of complicating the tributaries that drain into the Tennessee. Creating some backup there as well.
Emergency responders anticipate another significant water level rise before tomorrow morning. That's what we want to emphasize. This flooding threat, it's changing. It's not going away for everyone. We're seeing the water continue to rise in so many places. That changing threat had Huntsville firefighters out giving precautionary warnings today, and that's where we find WHNT News 19's David Kumbrock, who went out to speak with them.
Right, so I went out to the Grand Lake neighborhood. That is way down South Parkway. This is the area we're talking about here. See how close that is to the Tennessee River? That's how the threat is changing. We're not as worried about creeks and ponds, flash flooding, as we are about the fact that a lot of that rainwater that flooded the valley is now flowing into the Tennessee River.
In Grand Lake and nearby neighborhoods, firefighters go door to door to spread the word.
It's not over. Just because you saw the water go down from yesterday, it may not be over yet. We may still have some more issues.
They are not evacuating the neighborhood. They're just delivering a precautionary message.
If you're in the area of a tributary or a river, you need to be aware.
This kind of work, the pavement pounding kind, can save emergency workers valuable resources later on.
Right now, our water team, while we have some are out of town on vacation due to the holidays, our team has been working almost nonstop since yesterday morning. A lot of fatigue, but we're holding up there, getting some rotating through some breaks.
After all, the homes aren't the only concern.
It may be a situation where their house may not be prone to flood, but their route to come in and out may be prone to flood.
Areas like Ditto Landing already have plenty of water creeping in. U.S. government predictions from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration show that the water may not peak in the area until Sunday morning. David Kumbrock, WHNT News 19.
The National Weather Service in Huntsville has extended their flood warning until 7:15 tomorrow morning.
Thank you, David.
So let's get back to driving through those flooded areas. First and foremost, don't do this. We'll say it again because we can't say it enough. Turn around. Don't drown. If a road is covered in water, don't drive over it. Even if you know the elevation of the road, it could be washed out and you can't see it because of the water. Getting yourself into an unnecessarily dangerous situation can obviously end badly for you, and it puts even more strain on emergency services. Now, with roads potentially getting blocked and the possibility of further flooding, the Red Cross says they're standing by to potentially open up shelters. If you do end up needing one, here's what they ask.
We have prescription medicines, eyeglasses, anything as far as life-sustaining that would be needed. We ask that those items be brought in. Also, if you have children, make sure to bring any kind of formula, diapers, any items that they may need for their personal care.
So we just heard, bring medications. Do not bring your pets unless they're service animals. I'll repeat that. Don't bring your pets unless they're service animals. You need to be making plans for them now. Also, you may not bring any weapon of any kind into a Red Cross shelter. All the flooding has caused serious road issues all over the Tennessee Valley. Just take a look at Highway 36. This is a major state highway running through Morgan County. Now look at the amount of water just covering the roadway and surrounding areas. Obviously, this road is closed and this will affect many Monday morning commutes. Unfortunately, this is the situation in several places across the Tennessee Valley. And for a full list of road closures, head over to WHNT.com. You will find a story right on the homepage on road closures that our crews are constantly updating. With just some awful weather the past few days, let's check in now with meteorologist Jake Reed to see what we can expect over the next few days. Jake.
Hey Greg, just downstream from where that picture you just saw was taken, Pete Dobbs took this near the Coleman area, Lake Katoma. This is the most telling picture we have seen out of the hundreds of pictures that we've gotten over the past couple of days. Look at the power that the water had to bend this stop sign. You can also see another sign here just below that banner. Of course, all of the debris, the sand down here left in the roadway. This is the reason why we never recommend you travel into flooded areas, because you just cannot imagine how powerful the water is. And this is not over. Flood warnings continue across much of the Tennessee Valley. In fact, almost every single county in North Alabama under a flood warning. And the darker shades of green here, we're talking about the Paint Rock River, the Flint River, and also the Tennessee River from the Gunnersville Dam all the way to the Shoals under river flood warnings right now. And we do expect more rain, so the waters are already rising still from the rain that we saw on Christmas Day. More rain is on the way. Over the weekend, you see a couple of showers here in northern Jackson County, southern Franklin County. We're not talking about a lot of rain over the weekend. It's early next week that the rain chances go up, and we could see another 1 to 2 inches of rain on top of what we already have seen. Over the weekend, it's just going to be light showers, not a big problem. The heavy storms moving in on Monday, and look at this powerful system that we are watching. Area of low pressure here over northeastern Oklahoma, a stronger area of low pressure over southwest Texas, blizzard conditions, severe weather happening here. All of this is going to be moving to the east, and a flash flood watch has already been posted for the Tennessee Valley for Monday ahead of this next round of rain. We will time out those storm chances and also talk about the potential of severe weather on Monday in just a few minutes.
All right, thank you, Jake. Evidence of significant rain damage can be spotted throughout Marshall County. A truck on Loveless Street nearly submerged, and residents say the truck was completely covered Christmas night. Also in Gunnersville, massive mudslides on Sunset Drive, another at the Pee Wee football field, and the retaining wall, which holds up the parking lot at the elementary school, was knocked down into the stands. We have an update on a kayaker rescue out of DeKalb County. Two Birmingham men were rescued early Saturday morning after being stuck for more than 12 hours. The men were kayaking Friday at Little River Canyon when they got stranded. DeKalb County Emergency Management Director Anthony Clifton says one man was on a rock, the other on a bank. The men were rescued by rope with the assistance of multiple agencies about 4:30 this morning. The Tennessee Valley hit hard by rain Christmas Day, and some parts of Marshall County saw devastating damage. WHNT News 19's Kelsey Kern joins us now. Kelsey.
As you just saw, there was widespread flood damage in Marshall County. WHNT News 19 meteorologists say much of the county saw between 7 and 10 inches of rain. Part of the Hebron community saw so much flooding that people were traveling by boat to get across the road. Two homes are feet underwater in an area insurance companies assured them were flood-free zones.
I never would have thought. There's no way I would ever thought that this could happen. No way.
Rodney Stevens spent Christmas night at a hotel after his home of 14 years began taking on flood water. An unthinkable scenario for him and his family.
We was told that this was not a flood zone. So, never gave it a second thought. Because this has never happened.
There were no injuries, but now the home on Shelby Drive has more than 2 feet of water inside the house. and his family has been displaced for an unknown amount of time.
Got here this morning and we had two houses underwater. So I just like to ask anybody that wanted to. I know it's been Christmas. Yeah, people ain't got a lot, but any little bit's going to help these folks. They had no insurance.
Even though Stephen's home is partially submerged and has likely sustained extensive damage, he remains thankful.
But just pulling up, you know, and seeing it today, words can't describe. But, you know, like I said, we're all alive, and we'll be okay.
The Hebron Volunteer Fire Department would like to help the families impacted by the floods and will be taking donations and orchestrating volunteer efforts. For more information, go to WHNT.com. Kelsey Kern, WHNT News 19. Greg?
Thank you, Kelsey. Now, we've already been mentioning about using WHNT.com to get the latest information on this developing flooding story as far as roadways and closures. And if you have not downloaded our app, it's a great way to receive the very latest details on the go. We have several apps that you can download for free on your smartphone, tablet, or mobile device. Just search WHNT in the Apple Store or on Google Play. We are taking action to make sure you know about the weather where you live. These apps are a great tool to have in your weather arsenal. Coming up on WHNT News 9 at 10 on a Saturday, flames at the Space and Rocket Center. Coming up, we will have the latest on the building that caught fire and the damage left behind. And this is a live look at downtown Huntsville from our Jax Camera Network. Coming up, meteorologist Jake Reed breaks down the chances for a severe weather on Monday. Stay with us. Drivers on 565 got an eyeful of smoke this afternoon right next to the iconic spaceship over the Rocket City. As WHNT News 19 Siobhan Bryan reports, firefighters filled the lot at the Space and Rocket Center.
A 30-year-old building destroyed at one of Alabama's top tourist attractions.
Around 2:30, we got a call to the Space and Rocket Center of a possible fire. We arrived, we had flames showing from the roof of the building.
An employee and a firefighter visiting from another city pulled the fire alarm.
The building that caught fire is an old Mission to Mars building. It has not been used probably in 10 to 12 years.
U.S. Space and Rocket Center officials say no one was inside the now burned building, even though it's a busy Saturday here at the center. And it's been an even busier year for the tourist attraction, having dealt with yet another blaze just months ago.
The response to the last incident that occurred here several months ago, we were able to get in and reopen the next morning, and that fire occurred around 9:30 at night.
A projected 2,000 guests visited the center Saturday. Hall says the team evacuated everyone safely, and now it's business as usual.
A lot of folks are calling in about Star Wars. We're showing The Force Awakens. All of our movies are going to go on as scheduled. This fire has not impacted our main buildings, the Davidson Center or the main administration building.
The burned building will be taped off, but all operations will continue as planned. In Huntsville, Siobhan Bryan, WHNT News 19.
The cause and point of origin of the fire, that's still under investigation. Plenty of damage and inconvenience here in the Tennessee Valley and a really rough Christmas for our neighbors to the south. Emergency officials say a tornado touched down in Birmingham and Bessemer and damaged at least three homes. At least one person injured and taken to the hospital, and two others were pulled from collapsed homes. They're said to be okay. A fire chief says the damage is confined to one square mile area. A developing story, heartbreaking, out of Texas. Multiple tornadoes touched down this evening outside of Dallas. So far, officially, four people have died due to those storms. Tornado warnings started being issued Saturday afternoon in Dallas and they've continued into the night. The emergency manager for Ellis County says many homes have been destroyed and damaged during the fierce storm. In other areas, there's been extensive damage done to homes, a church, vehicles stretching from Garland, that's about 20 miles northeast of Dallas, to Glen Heights, 20 miles south of the city. The full extent of the damage won't be known until daylight Sunday.
Now, your weather where you live forecast with meteorologist Jake Reed.
Ravaged is the only word I think accurately describes this picture here. This is another one from Pete Dobbs out at Lake Atoma. I want to just take a moment here. I want you to soak this in and just see the power that the water had when it came rushing through here. Of course, this is just outside the city of Coleman, and the water was as high as this road up here. You see how it's kind of torn this road up here. Of course, down on the bridge, you see all of the debris as the water was just rushing through. Several feet of water came through here, and these pictures pictures, again, just illustrate the absolute danger that flash flooding can cause. And the risk is not over because we've got more rain on the way. The Christmas Day floods, that was the wettest Christmas Day on record here in Huntsville. And now we are in the top 10 wettest Decembers in Huntsville on record, 9.25 inches so far. Thankfully, we will not get anywhere close to the wettest December on record, which happened back in 1990. Over 18.5 inches of rain fell during that December. But this has been bad enough because it fell in such a short amount of time. In fact, one area we're watching closely, the Tennessee River at Whitesburg. Of course, a lot of people have property near this area. The current stage is almost at 22 feet. It's forecast now to crest almost at 23 feet. And of course, that is way above flood stage. The record crest set back in 1973 is about 26 feet, so this likely will go down in the top five all-time highest crest for the Tennessee River at Whitesburg. And you see, we've got these dark shades of green here. These are the river flood warnings for the Tennessee River, the Paint Rock River, and also the Flint River. And even into western Lawrence County, Big Nance Creek, it is in major flood stage right now. I've been talking with some people on Twitter who are telling me in areas of Moulton and other parts of the county, they've got several feet of water still on the ground right now. And unfortunately, there is more rain on the way. This weekend, it's not going to be very significant. A couple of showers here or there, it's not going to amount to a whole lot. It's early next week, Monday, in fact, that we do expect more rain to move back in. You see, here over southern Franklin County, just a couple of showers. But what I'm watching to the west, this is the same system that caused the deadly tornado in the southeastern portion of Dallas. And look behind this cold front. We've got a lot of cold air, blizzard conditions over eastern New Mexico, the western Texas panhandle. And this is one of the most outrageous maps I think we've seen in quite some time. Flash flood watches ahead of the system, ice storm warnings in the cold air, blizzard warnings covering several states. This is going to be a major system, and that is what is headed to the Tennessee Valley. Now, it's not going to be as bad here as what it is there, but keep in mind, we have a serious flooding problem happening now, and this rain moving in is not going to help at all. In fact, by 9 o'clock Monday morning, heavy line of thunderstorms moving in, gusty winds, a very good possibility. And of course, the heavy rain, we certainly do not need any more of that. As the front continues to move through, by 11 o'clock, that heaviest rain moving toward Huntsville. The bad thing I'm seeing here is that east of I-65, this front's going to slow down. More rain is going to fall over the areas that absolutely do not need it. And because of that, we have a flash flood watch that has already been posted. This is going to be in effect early Monday morning all the way through Monday evening. Now, behind that rain, we do have another chance of rain coming through on Wednesday. That's about a 60% chance. Then we start to cool down. In fact, even as early as Tuesday, we're back in the 50s, but highs by next weekend, not even warmer than the mid-40s. And yes, we will be adding to our freezes late next week. But we're watching Monday closely, not only because of the threat of some wind, but also any more rain is really going to be a big problem.
All right. Monday, circle it on your calendar. Pay attention to what's going on. Thank you, Jack. Appreciate it. Tomorrow's episode of Undercover Boss features a Nestle Tollhouse restaurant in Athens. Nestle Tollhouse Cafe COO goes undercover to check out how the store is running. And she experiences a sugar crash when she fails to meet her own customer service requirements. And here's a sneak peek.
Hi there.
Hey.
How are you?
I just want an iced coffee.
Okay.
Is this gonna be all for y'all today?
Yes. Bridget, I gotta do the iced vanilla latte.
Okay. The iced vanilla latte is going to be...
Okay, I'll follow it. That's right.
Yep.
I'll follow it.
Remember, KJ, you're working that drive-thru. One of the things that Katie did not do that well was just speed.
Don't you love it when the boss realizes it's not as easy as it looks? The company franchises more than 150 dessert and bakery cafes globally, and the Athens location is located on Highway 72. That episode airs tomorrow night on CBS right here at 8 o'clock Central Time. Weather couldn't stop Alabama from making its way to the Cotton Bowl. The Tide getting to Dallas earlier today in advance of its college football playoff game against Michigan State. We'll hear from head coach Nick Saban, right after the break. Before we get out of here, we'll leave you with a military greeting.
This military greeting is sponsored by the law firm of Senior Timberlake and League.
How y'all doing? It's Corporal Osborne, United States Army, Greenbrier, Tennessee. I want to wish everybody back home a happy holidays. Miss and love y'all.
It's been 3 weeks since Alabama beat Florida for its second straight SEC title. Now we're just 5 short days from the Tide's return to the field. Nick Saban and his team arriving in Dallas today ahead of its college football playoff game on New Year's Eve against Michigan State. After landing in the Lone Star State, the team buses got the coaches and players to the Hilton Anatolia Hotel just before noon. Not long after that, Nick Saban's team was on the field at Coppell High School for its first game week practice. Now, getting to the Cotton Bowl wasn't easy with the severe weather we've been dealing with here in Alabama, but Coach says just about everyone is present and accounted for.
It certainly was, you know, a difficult circumstance last night, but we didn't have an issue, at least with the group that came with us, which was probably 90% of the guys. Some of the guys from this part of the country and out west are meeting us here. I have not heard of any issues that we have with any of those guys to this point.
We won't hear from Nick Saban tomorrow, but Lane Kiffin and select offensive players are available. It'll be our first opportunity to speak with the Tide's offensive coordinator this season. The trip was a little shorter for the Auburn Tigers, the team arriving in Birmingham today for the Birmingham Bowl against Memphis. The Tigers will practice in town throughout the week with the game scheduled for 11 a.m. at Legion Field on December 30th. You know, the Cotton Bowl is actually at AT&T Stadium, not the real Cotton Bowl, where Washington and Southern Miss played the Heart of Dallas Bowl today. First quarter, Huskies up by 7. Nick Mullins to Michael Thomas splits 2 defenders, then turns on the Jets 56 yards for the touchdown. We have a tie ball game. A lot of scoring at the Cotton Bowl. Washington with an 11-point lead just before the half. The Golden Eagles cut into that with this Ito Smith touchdown, but the Huskies just wouldn't stop scoring. Third quarter, Mules Gaskin on the carry up the middle, breaks outside, and he gone. Gaskin, 181 yards and 4 touchdowns in the game. Washington tops Southern Miss in the Zaxby's Heart of Dallas Bowl, 44-31. Just down I-20 in El Paso, Texas. Mark Richt's new home, Miami, playing Washington State in the Sun Bowl. First quarter, Hurricanes down by 7. Brad Kaya guns it to Stacy Cooley for the touchdown. We have a tie game here. The Cougars would retake the lead on a field goal. Then Luke Falk finds a soft spot in the coverage. Perfect pass on the mark to Gabe Marks. That adds 6 points to the lead. The snow really started coming down in the second half. Crazy to see that in El Paso, Texas, of all places. Miami down by 6, knocking on the door, but Mark Walton on the carry fumbles the ball. It's recovered by Washington State. The Cougars knock off the U in the Hyundai Sun Bowl, 20-14. Well, this time last year, the Havoc was an afterthought in the Southern Professional Hockey League. The team had just 3 wins and was well out of the playoff hunt, but that's not the case in 2015. After retooling in the offseason, Huntsville finds itself near the top of the standings, just 2 points out of first. A packed house over at the Von Braun Center the day after Christmas to watch the Havoc take on Columbus. First period, Huntsville on the power play. Nick Schneider, the one-timer, initially blocked. They have a chance on the rebound, but it won't go. Another opportunity for the Havoc here. Puck works its way around to Nolan Kayser. The one-timer's deflected. Still no score in the game. No goal for Huntsville in the first period.
Here
but
we go.
This fight, definitely a win. Jeremy Bernice giving Al Graves the business. That's definitely a win for the Havoc. As far as the hockey game goes, Columbus wins 3-0, but he won the fight, and that's all that really matters, right?
Reminds me of the story you tell us about why you got kicked out of that football game. We'll be right back. And let's talk about Monday again, and as it relates to, you know, what's going on in Dallas, and that's headed here, but you mentioned it's not going to be that strong when it gets here. Give us the overhead view here.
Right. First of all, let's touch on the weekend. We still have roads that are flooded, mm-hmm. still have roads that are washed out. I don't expect much rain tonight or tomorrow. A couple of showers, yes, and that's not going to be a big deal. Now, Monday, we've got heavy rain and storms moving through, and this is a really powerful system causing a lot of problems out to the west. And even though we don't expect the same problems here, you have to understand, we already are starting with a whole lot of problems, and we're expecting maybe 1 to 2 inches more of rain. And I know that doesn't really sound like a lot, considering we just had some places with 10 inches, but it's not going to help the flooding situation. Many of the rivers forecast to crest late tonight, early tomorrow. That's just going to slow that process down with that rain moving through. So heavy rain, gusty wind, those are two of the main concerns that I'm concerned about. Then by Tuesday, we start to cool down. Wednesday, we're back in the 50s. More rain, rain on Wednesday. A lot of that, though, may stay just to the south of us. And then we start to get cold by next weekend. High temperatures back in the mid-40s.
Wow. It's just been a marathon. I'm worn out. I mean, I know you're worn out. I haven't had to deal with what you've had to guys have had to deal with.
Yeah, a marathon is exactly right. But just we have had so many different kinds of weather over the past couple of days, the tornadoes, now the floods, and more rain's on the way.
Very good. We want to leave you with some incredible video. The folks, Pete Dobbs and Awaken Films, were combining some of their video from drones. It's absolutely extraordinary, some of the flooding that we're seeing. This is some of the video. We leave you with this tonight. Again, this is from Pete Dobbs and Awaken Films.